Guys, Kyle Piper here. Welcome to Atheist Ascended episode number 10. Yeah. Between this episode and last episode, my little brother has built a house in our town. It's very good. His name is Cal. And yeah, just a little house. Very nice. Very, very nice. And yeah, so that's literally the only addition to the town so far since this episode. Oh. And I don't remember whether this was completely finished last episode. But yeah, I completely finished this thing, as in everything. Nothing left to build on this. Okay then. And today, we are going to be building the path. So, what I'm going to do is basically I'm going to break random blocks along the way to the... random blocks on the way to the, along the path. So, yes. But while I'm doing that, I'm going to be answering some questions which people have been asking me, and what the hell is that? Ah, boy. Answering some random questions which people have asked me. Question number one. What is my opinion on Red Ninja 685's head? Okay, that is a weird one. That is a very weird one. Honestly, it looks quite generic, it does. I'm sorry, but it really does. It's very generic in my opinion. I need to get that. And so yeah, that's question one. It's very generic, but it does look like, I don't know, royalty or something like that, because he is the leader of the nation. Ooh, I'll take that. Thank you. Random iron. That is the one thing my town is running low on. Believe it or not, iron. We've got plenty of diamonds, plenty of everything except iron. Okay, so, yeah, we're just taking out random blocks. Not trying to give it any pattern. Next question. Would I consider covering the Daggerlands in sand because the Arsalak is starting to look like the Daggerlands? Now, that's basically referencing that a lot of people come to Arsalak and basically take the sand they do, which is not nice at all. They take the sand and make the place look hideous. And a lot of people are not happy about that. And if you didn't know, the Daggerlands is like a wasteland, it is. So, yeah, that's what he's talking about there. If you didn't know, I'm going to be filling in these holes with gravel, I am. And those two questions were from Ollie Nyman. I think that's how you pronounce it. Ollie Neiman, or something like that. I'm 100% sure. Next question is my top five staff members. Top five staff members. That's a tough one. Let me think. The Dee Dee has to be on there, because she's freaking... You got nothing to compare her to. Nothing. Yeah. There's Finyol, who... Very good friend of mine. There's Vorsk. These, I can't think of an order for them, because that's really mean to do that too. There's Svarjan. He is actually quite a good friend of mine, he is. Well, in my opinion, I don't know from his. But, there's also, that's three? Yeah, that's three. This is quite difficult. There's Who else is there? Who's on at the moment? Oh yeah, Red Ninja. Duh. Duh. That's pretty obvious. Who else? None of those people really. Oh, what's his name? Blah, 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 blah. It is... Oh, I can't think of his name. Barney. Yeah, he is really good. He is, in my opinion, really good. And next question is my top three nations. Now, I'm going to do something a little bit different with this. My top three nations. I'm going to take my A3's V1 version as well as the V2 version into consideration. I am now, but because of that, V1 Roraglaw is very homey to me. Very homey. Because that was like the nation I started on, and yeah. It's basically my... I feel like that place is like the most homey sort of feeling place that there is on the server. So, there has ever been on the server, so... And that, I don't know why, but it feels like that's the one that I'm most familiar with. So, yeah. And I've always been in Roraglaw until I made this town. So, yeah. So, Roraglaw is my number one. I'm sorry, all Selakites. But, B2, where's my bloody... stone. I can't see it. Where the hell's my stone? Where the hell did it go? I swear I had plenty of stone. Oh, whatever. No, that can't tell. Where the hell did my stone go? I swear I had plenty. Oh, I've got to head back. Okay, so where was I? Yeah. So, reason I'm actually having the V1 included is just because V1 Roraglaw was so good. I only visited two nations in my entire time of V1, only ever, and those two were Roraglaw, which is where I was living, and Vivona, just because they had that market town, clear crystal something, I don't know, it's crystal something, and yeah, so that's the only reason why I just added the V1 option. Now, for my third favourite, I would honestly have to say Ithero. Now, I hate Kalistor. I hate it. It is my least favourite city in all of A3s, because it is just a mess to look at. In my opinion, it's just a maze. It's a maze that if you fall out of off the edge of the maze, meaning like the bloody platforms, the like streets, you cannot get back up. Ever. It is awful in my opinion. I'm sorry to the build team, but I really do not like Kalistor. I'm not sure whether the original one was like that, but yeah, I really do not like it. So, yeah. But everything else about Ithero, I really like. Like the islands, all the... I don't know why, but everything there looks so cool, it does. Everything there except Kalistor. Okay, those two questions were from Michigamer. Okay, next question. If you could pick one thing in A3's world, Which one of these would you like in the real world? Okay. That is a tough one. Though, just like everything, whenever there is some kind of magic or something, I would want that. Just the magic. Or the hero system or something like that. That's what I would like. So yeah, that's a pretty easy one. It's mainly because I just like the concept of magic, because it's magic. And what is my favorite crop? That would honestly have to be carrots, that would. For the sole reason that they are, you don't have to smelt them, and I have clogged inventory. I don't need cactus. Just for the sole reason that you don't have to cook them. There's no processing need them, you just pull them out, eat them. Brilliant. Plus, you can turn them into golden carrots, which are the highest saturation food in the entire game. So, that is really good. That is. It's like, that's amazing in my opinion. Potatoes, yeah, they are good. Ooh, coal, thank you. I shall take that. Okay, ooh, some more. Jeez, coal. Okay, yeah. Potatoes are pretty good, they are. Just because you can cook them, you can, and then they're. Oh, wait, these aren't even bloody cooked. Whoops. I forgot to cook them, it looks like. So yeah, you can basically you can cook them, you can, but you don't have to basically. You can let me finish that. You can cook them, but that basically costs coal. And when you're starting off, that's horrible because you need all the coal you can get. Well, most people don't, but I do because I hate mining. I know it's in the title of the game, Minecraft, but I do not like mining. I just find it boring. Caving, I love. I love caving, but I cannot just go mining. Branch mining, I can't do it. It's just so boring. It's so dreary. It's just bleh. That's a word, isn't it? Bleh. Okay, and those questions were from Sanders. Next question is, how did I find out about aetheries? Now, unlike most people where they hear about it from one of their friends or something, I didn't. I found out about it basically by chance I did. I was just looking for a themed server I was, because I was for some reason I was into those. I'd recently got banned from a server which I basically just went on, and then I got banned like within 5 seconds. I have no idea what the hell I did. And yeah, so that was a pirate themed one. And so I just looked up some medieval themed ones, and I came across aetheries. That was like in, oh, I was in grade 10 or 11, so one of those two. I'm now out of school. So yeah, that was about 3 years ago. That was two or 3 years ago, 2.5. And yeah, that's was how I found it. I just, ooh, what the hell is this? You don't usually find that underneath. So yeah, I found it just by chance, just by googling medieval Minecraft servers. So yeah. Next question. Oh great, I gotta switch these. Next question is, what is my most memorable experience? That would have to be, I'm just doing that so I can tell. Would have to be, ooh, lovely gold. I like gold. Ooh, iron. I like that as well. It's all good. It's all good. I do not need those torches. I do not want the cobblestone. There we go. My most memorable experience would have to be building the what is it? What is it called? The thingamabob. The blah blah blah. I cannot think of a word. The Seriously, I cannot think of what it's called. The thingamabob, the disco, in my first town in A3s, in V1. The town of Ruins of Xerath, which is the namesake of New Xerath. Yeah, so I built a redstone disco. I did. I could easily remake it, I could, because all the mechanics still work. And yeah, basically it was a disco that had flashing floor patterns and stuff. And yeah, that was really fun to work on, that was. And the end result was just amazing. So yeah, let's cover this part up here. Do not want to have to look in the cave. There. And there, there. There, okay. So yeah, that was. This part's gonna be a bit narrow, this part is. That was honestly my favorite part of A3s, that was. The building that disco was like. It was so fun. So fun. It's like. I built a disco in a medieval world. That doesn't even make sense. It's that cool that it does not make sense. Oh, it was so fun. I might remake it in the future, but I don't know. I have no idea whether I will or not. Oh, more iron. I'm really liking this iron I'm finding. It's very nice. And next question is what? Oh yeah, I just read that one. Jeez. Have I enjoyed my time here? Yeah, I've loved A3s. I wouldn't be here after freaking 3 years if I just hated it. It's like, why would I stay? Am I a masochist? No, I'm not a masochist. So yeah, of course I've enjoyed my stay here, my time here. Not stay, I'm not a bloody hotel. So yeah. Next question. Oh wait, those questions were from Zef Dahariq. I think that's how you pronounce it. Zef Dahariq. My next question is, do I like Eura? Who doesn't? Who doesn't like money? Jeez, that's like asking, hey, do you not want to win the lottery? It's like, well, actually, a lot of people wouldn't because they don't like it. Pressure, but. That was a bad analogy. That was a really bad analogy. So yeah, I like it, right? It's very, very nice. Oh, that's too close. What am I doing? Jeez. Yeah, of course I like Eura. Eura is brilliant. Eura makes the world go round. That was from Akila Tashar. I think that's how you pronounce her name. The next one is, would I be opposed if Akila Tashar gave me money? And this is like, Akila Tashar gives. He's asking me if Akila Tashar would be okay with giving him money. Not me, him. That's very confusing the wording I notice now. Sure, why not? Eat your heart out. Next question that was from Castor. Oh great, this is gonna be a bit steep here. Next question is Do I support red sandstone, or do you think it should be smashed, sanded into a million pieces and scattered across the four corners of Arsalak? That's very aggressive. Very, very aggressive. I bloody love it. It's brilliant. It looks so cool. If anything, there should be more variants of blocks. I love the fact that there's variants of certain blocks. Let me just, my throat's sore. Yeah, I love the fact that there's variants of certain blocks. It makes the world a bit more authentic. And makes it more lived in. Like, there's no one type of sand. Bloody hell, not all beaches and deserts have the exact same sand. Red sand's very Australian, in my opinion. Because, well, we have red dirt. So that's, it's different. It's kind of different, but it's basically the same thing. So yeah. I really like block variants and stuff, but when you say smash and spread, that would mean that it would be spread throughout Salak, so that would make it more prevalent. So I might have to choose the second option. I would like it smashed, because that means there'll be more of it, and more means better. Oh great, I'm gonna have to bloody fill in this here. I hate it when people do this. This is what I was talking about with the Daggerlander thing. People are taking sand and not replacing it, making this. And I just had a block lag. I'll just fill in this. There we go. Make this look a little bit more natural. And blah 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 blah. There, brilliant. Now I just gotta cover this in sand. Yay. Yeah. So that question was from Halbard, like a halberd, but it's a bard. Ooh, that's falling. The next question is, why am I so amazing? I have no idea why I'm so amazing. I am unbelievably amazing, and I hate that bloody macro mod thing. I hate that one. How it does that. I know it's useful, but it just gets things so many things wrong so many times. It's like, no, give me the exact block I just had. And this falls again. Great. Oh, great. So, yeah, there we go. That's filled in. There we go. That makes things a hell of a lot neater. Let me just break that one. Okay. Why am I so amazing? I don't know. Maybe it's because I am brilliant at everything. Except everything. If that makes any sense. Okay. Turn the page over, because I got this written down on a piece of paper, so I do not forget things. Okay, the next question is... Wait. Yeah, and that question, why am I so amazing, was from Gallen... Dan Thewasi, I think I misspelled his name. I think I put double A in there. Okay, I just got paused for a second. It was just my dad coming home from work, saying good morning to me. What was I saying? Turn the page over. What? Next question is, what's my opinion on Dee Dee? Diadorn. She is... evil. That's my opinion. She's evil. She wants to eat everybody's soul. And that is why she is one of my favorite moderators, big admins or whatever. I can never remember what the bloody difference. Yeah, it's admin. Because bloody hell, she is... I don't know. She's got a very good personality, in my opinion. Oh, that's too close. Very good personality. But yeah, that is my opinion. And Rexy is chirping. Isn't that right, Rexy? And he's saying, hello, Rex. Okay. If I had to nuke one nation, what nation would it be? Okay, then. I'm honestly gonna get a bit of anger, but a what I say to answer this question. I'm going to say, and before you get angry, hear me out. I would probably get rid of, I'm just going to say get rid of, because nuke sounds way more aggravating. Probably, what's it called? Thingamabob. The Alara. The sole reason that it's very... I'm gonna get a lot of flack for this. Very generic, I find it. It's like... It's like the archetypal, medieval place it is. It's like, it's literally something that, like, it's something that you would find in nearly every single, fantasy thing. Because it's just, it's very bland, in my opinion. It's, all the other ones have, like, all their own, like, little niches and stuff. Well, I don't know, it's just bland. Just bland. And now all the Alara Raiders come after me because I insulted them all. That's right, Rexy. Yeah. Come here, Rex. I'm gonna try and get him over to me. Come here. Come here, Rexy. No, he doesn't want to. He's just staring at my hand. Oh, we're almost at the end. Here we are. Just over this ridge. Oh, and that opinion on DD question was from Mitchy Gamer. Yes, Rex. The next question is from, and next question is, do I prefer cog oil or roast duck? Now, I don't want to be mean or anything, but I really don't like Dagger Landing cooking. It's Daggerlandic, however you say it. It's honestly not very appealing to me. Maybe it's due to the excessive amounts of turpentine in their food, but I really don't like it. I'm sorry about that, but I really don't like turpentine in my food. It's not nice. Because it's poison, and it will kill you. Stop eating it. So, yeah. Get rid of this. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh. Gotta fill in this bloody patch. And those two questions about, nuking and Thingamabob. And the cog oil was from, Halbard again. Oh, God, don't you give me that sand. Give me the white sand. Yeah. Another thing about roast duck, I've actually had that. It is so nice. So nice. At a Chinese place I did, it was really nice, it was. So, I can honestly say that I would take the roast duck over cog oil any day. And I am out of sand. Yes. Great. Let's basically just continue the path and yeah, we can get some more sand while doing it. Oh, bloody hell, sand everywhere. Don't want that. I do not want that. There. Yeah, so roast duck is very, very nice, in my opinion. Next question is why Salak? Why did I join Salak? I don't know why. I love the whole Middle Eastern theme that it has. It's just, it seems very natural to me. I don't know why. It's just something about it. Something about it just makes it perfect for me. Perfect. Let's put one there. Oh, bloody hell. Stop doing that. Yeah, that's really about it. I'm gonna bloody just skip this section here. Fill that one there. Oh, we are nearly at the end. Yeah, Salak is just a very, very nice place it is. It's just, I know it's very, it's tribal based and stuff like that. I'm not trying to mean or anything, but that's literally what it is. Oh, let's get rid of this bloody thing. I do not want that. Okay, yeah, so I like that aspect. I do. It's very, very authentic in my opinion. It reminds me a lot of the Dothraki from Game of Thrones. I think that's how you pronounce it, Dothraki. It just seems genuine for some reason, and I really like that about it. Plus, I love sand. I don't know why I love sand so much, but I love it. It looks so cool. So cool, it just seems very clean and pristine and stuff. Yes, Rexy. Rexy is on my foot at the moment. Is there anything I change on A3s? Without getting comments from people saying, oh, we can't do that because such and such and such and such, it lags a lot. Well, I would honestly say I would like more particles. Though, before you say it will lag and stuff, in 1.9, they have remade it so that particles are no longer entities, so they will not lag at all. Well, they'll still lag, but nowhere near as much. So, there. That is what I would like. More particles. 1.9, A3 Ascended, more particles. That is what I want. More pretty particles. I want your prettiest ones. The prettiest ones. That's my British accent. Prettiest ones. And those two questions were from Olin Nyman. I can't say your name. Just say Ollie. Ollie sounds right. You're an Ollie. That's your name. Yeah. Next question is my favorite nation. Even though I'm currently in Salak. Oh god, bloody hell. Rex nearly yanked on the cord holding my DS up. It's like, do not yank on that. It's like on the charger is on my desk. Like, do not yank on that, Rex. It's very bad, Rexy. Yeah. Yeah. He's saying yeah to me. Rexy, come here. He doesn't want to. He's just talking to himself. Oh, hello. Somebody doesn't have a town. Oh, it's an alt. Okay, yeah, so it has to be, Roriglaw. Has to be Roriglaw. Just because that is my home nation. It is. That's where I started my journey in Aetheries. Come here, Rexy. He's on my hand. You gonna talk, Rexy? No? Now you wanna crawl down onto my lap to go on the floor again? Sure. Oh, he hates being on my shoulder while I'm out on my desk. Hates it. Would rather be on the floor or my lap. Like a bloody dog. I'm running out of sand. What's that? Sandstone, I don't need that. What was I saying? I cannot remember. Yeah, so it has to be Rorgler. Next question is my favourite class. Now, that has to be Warden. Because Warden was my first ever Tier 4. It was the one which I built everything up for and stuff. And then leveling became insanely easy in V2. So, there's that. So, yeah. So, that is it. I love the thing which I love so much about it is that there's so many strategies you can do with it. You got the wolves. You got so many things you can do. All because of just how it's made. It's a very tactical class, in my opinion. Very tactical class. And me being a huge fan of tactical games, I'm currently replaying what's it called? Fire Emblem Awakening at the moment on my DS. And yeah, so I love tactical games, and it is a very tactical class. You got wolves, you got bows, you got swords, you got everything. Everything, and don't chew on that paper. That's my question paper, Rexy. Yeah, so that is my favourite class. When and how did I find A3 so much? I already answered this. Oh, you just took a huge dump on my leg, Rex. That's disgusting. Ew. There's poo everywhere. Yuck. I'm going to clean this up. Okay, he's now off me. And I just cleaned up all that bloody poo. Oh, the one thing I hate about birds. They poo all the time. And all on you. Oh. What was the question? When and how did I find A3s? I found it just by basically looking up medieval servers and, yep, finding it. That's literally it. And that was in, like, when I was either in grade 10 or 11, one of those two. The sand. I know I shouldn't be using the sand because I gotta save it up for there, but whatever. Whatever. Actually, I can just crush cobblestone. Forgot about that. I forgot. The next thing. Oh, that's the town. This is it. Okay, then. Well, we've reached the border we have. So, yeah. I said that before. And the last question, the final question is, which Aetherian god would I like to be, if any? Well, I'm not trying to be blasphemous here, but I would honestly like to be Alaka, because then I could just flood the world. I would control the majority of all of A3s. It would be amazing. Absolutely amazing. Because I could control. And I could control everything. I shall be more powerful than everything in my domain, that is. Bloody hell, give me the right sand. That is the final question. Stop. Bloody hell, I need more. That's sand. Okay. So, yeah. I'm now going to fill in these slots, these holes, with some gravel. And I shall show you the end result of that. Oh, and before I do anything else, those last four questions were from RedNinja685. So thank you. Okay, now that the path is done, we're going to add a few decorations to what we are. I might put a tree here. An acacia tree, of course. There we go, with some nice shade. Yeah, that's what I like. I like putting like little decorations along the road. I know that somebody's going to probably chop it down one day, but... Oops, I missed a spot, it looks like. Yeah, if you're wondering why this road is more sporadic compared to most roads, that is because it's a town. It's not very big, so there's not going to be many people coming to it. Simple reason. I'll put one here. Why would somebody have that much yellow dye? Oh boy. That's a bit of a low one. But it looks nice. That's what we're going for here. Make it look nice. Get a few more carrots. And head up here, put up another tree. I think over here. That would look nice. Oops. Put that there and grow. Ooh, yes, that does look nice. Okay then. No, that doesn't look nice. That doesn't. Let's put red sand there. I've got plenty of red sand now. That's good. Very, very good. Let's put one here. Put one of these trees here. Dirt. Where do I put that dirt? Dirt, dirt, dirt. There. Grow you. Brilliant. Let's put a sand down. Oh, whatever. That's not sand, that's sandstone. Sand. And there. Brilliant. It's got little trees along the way. Makes it look very, very nice. I might put one up on a hill up here. Or down here. Ooh, that looks very nice. That does. Very, very nice. Actually, better yet, we can make this like a little pond. We can. Make this a little pond. Make a little waterfall. That would look a lot better. Let's do that. That's right, Rexy. Yeah. Rex is chirping in the background. Put that down. Don't really care. Nobody's gonna see it. So, let's cover that up. Oh, great. Why? Actually, let's make the bottom red sand, because red sand looks better with water. Let's do that. Just fill in, get rid of all this sand here. I know I was just complaining about people removing sand, but we're going to be replacing it, so. Just get it all there. That's basically it. And let's fill it up with red sand. This shall look very, very nice, this shall. Nice pond. There we go. And a bit more. Geez, that's high. Okay, I'm gonna use other blocks underneath that. Do I have many? No, I do not. That's great. That's always good. Let's mine a bit of stone up. Cobble. So we can fill in this hole. Oh, iron. Brilliant. I'm just finding iron, iron, iron. I love iron because I do not have much of it. There we go. Let's try and fill that in. How much do we have? 15. That should be good. Should be. Not going to be. Should be. Whoops, no, not these ones. Actually, yes. Yes, these ones. These ones here. Let's cover this up. I might make, yeah, I'll go around here and then waterfall down there. That's gonna look really good. So yeah, I'm gonna just build this little pond here and I'll see you with the end result. Okay, there it is. I've got some sugar canes, I've got some vines there and an acacia tree. Looks very good. And when you come back around here, there is a little waterfall that leads down into the mine. Let's not go down there. because we are not finished. So I have a few more things to make that look a little bit prettier. I tried to get lily pads, but nobody was auctioning them. So if I do get some in the future, I'll put them in here, because that will look very, very nice. That will. Very nice. Okay, let's keep going up. Up here. I want to put one up on a hill, I do, just to make it look very, very nice. So I shall put one up here. Here. This is a good spot. Very good spot. Let's put that there. Let's rearrange my inventory a bit. And bone meal. There we go. Very nice. And I'm wanting to get rid of these torches as well. I'll come back for those. Okay, and up here, put one final one up here. Should look very, very nice. Just around the corner up here. Here, that looks nice. That will look very nice. Oh, jeez, that took heaps of bone meal. Probably because of this sand here. Speaking of sand, let's fill in the sand. Because that is we need this in for it to look nice. Because it currently does not look nice. Looks like shite. Okay, let's put this in. Yes, that's the right sand. Bloody hell, I hate it when it does that. Let me pick it up. Thank you. How much has he been in that for? Oh, 100. Jeez, no way. No way. 100. Why would you... whatever. Whatever. That's a bloody rip-off, in my opinion. That is a rip-off. So let's fill this in. Make it look very, very nice. That's right, Rexy. Rexy's on my foot. And there we are. We are out. But yeah, this looks very nice. Let's put another one here. Let's put a few bit more gravel here. Just because we didn't have any like perspective or anything like that before. But now we do. So yeah, this is a path. Very, very nice. I'm actually going to chop down one of these trees, it's just so I can put up a few more, and I can get the wood, so yeah. I'll see you in a bit, once I have gotten some more saplings. Okay, after much farming of the same tree so many times because it bloody wouldn't give me a freaking sapling, finally grown it. So now... I'm just going to remove the torches and we can have a little walk along it. I'll see you in a bit. Okay, so this is the path. Got a little sign here saying new surface this way. I might change that sign later, it looks a bit ugly, but yeah, got here is the path. Very, very good. Later on, when the tank gets bigger, I'll probably just add a bit more to this every now and then, just make it look a little bit bigger, and show that it's being used more and stuff. So, yeah. Because that's what I think it signifies. The gravel isn't actually a path. What it is basically the ground just being stepped on that much that it's getting hardened up. And, yeah, so the more people going through means the more... gravel there is. Which, oh, I missed one. There. And another one I missed. Yeah, I've seen a few that I've missed as I'm going by. So when I do spot them, I'll just fill them in with gravel. So yeah. I think that is about it. I really like this pond here. It's very, very nice and tranquil it is. Very good. And down here, this is a very nice road, Very nice. So you can easily get from the National Road to New Zareth. Easy as can be. Okay then. Almost there. Just around the corner, and there's a redstone torch. Pick that up. There's a few more torches. And yeah, that is a great eating. That is it. It's very good. I made it like a little stop around. It stops around here and just basically just circles this thing because that's the staircase. But yeah, that is about it for this episode. If you like this video, leave a like. If you loved it, subscribe. And if you want to talk to me, just leave a comment below. I always read them.